Yeah, I mean, basically what we're doing is we're trying to formulate a kind of new kind of funky music. You know, kind of based on tradition, but playing kind of inside the groove. So it's this is a very new process.
Yeah.
You guys are getting really the newest kind of point of the band, just getting to know what we want to do. Daryl and I grew up in Chicago together, and we learned kind of music, you know, on the same scene, and we played together. He went one way, I went another way. You know, he went more into the, you know, rock, playing with a lot of stars. I went in a way where I was playing my music, developing my CDs and everything. And we always said we would come back together one time. I know Will since he was a teenager. Will would come to the Village Vanguard when I was playing with Elvin Jones.
Yeah.
He was already a drummer who was trying to, you know, come up. Then he got the gig with Living Color and became also a big star on the drums.
We met at a music convention in the United States in January. And just started, you know, talking like, man, we got to play together. We got to, you know, we got to make a place, you know. And so I was telling him that I was going to be playing with Will in Los Angeles maybe a few weeks after that show. And he said, you know, I play with Will, you know, that's maybe the three of us together. And I said, no, that's great. That'd be wonderful, you know. So we just decided to try it, and we talked about it, and things came together, and here we are. And I think that his work is so connected to the history of the blues, and also to jazz, also to rock music, to African music. It's just so rich, you know. Yeah, you know, it's so rich. So I think it's a great opportunity for me. Yeah, I'm very happy to be here. Well, I mean, the thing is, I really enjoy doing both.
Yeah.
You know, even with the Stones, it's great to play in a stadium, and then it's also great to play like in Paradiso with them, you know, because the audience is right there.
Mm-hmm.
And the same thing is true here. I mean, I didn't know that there were so many clubs the size that we've been playing all over Germany and Austria. So I'm imagining they're everywhere.
Do the Stones still make music off the stage? Do you, I'm interested in
constantly.
Do you sit together and make music?
Yeah, musicians do, you know.
Musicians do?
Musicians do. It's not just business or anything with them. I mean, you know, I've been reading Keith's book, and one of the things that surprised me, I've always known that they knew a lot about blues music.
Yes, of course.
But reading the book, you realize how deeply they, how far they went in, how much they studied to get these things together. And like all musicians, man, there's always jamming. You know, I was with Keith a few weeks ago, and we're sitting there together, and before too long, he's holding guitar, and I'm holding guitar. So it's just, that's gonna always be the case. It's always gonna be the case.